Thank you for watching. Thank you for joining us today. Last week, we began a lesson in the book of Revelation, chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. And we talked about the different ways to interpret the Bible. We talked about a literal interpretation. We talked about an ethical interpretation. We talked about symbolic and mythical interpretations. And we specifically said that as you look at the book of Revelation, you will probably need to look at it symbolically and mythically, because there are some messages, there are some things that Christ is revealing to us in the book of Revelation for your blessings. That is the title of the message, for your blessings. We talked about the four horses. Now we're going to look at the four riders, and we're going to look at the four judgments. But before we get to that, let's read our scripture once again. As I watched, the Lamb broke the first of seven seals on the scroll. Then I heard one of the four living beings say with a voice like thunder, "Come." I looked up and saw a white horse standing there. Its rider carried a bow, and a crown was placed on his head. He rode out to win many battles and gain victory. When the Lamb broke the second seal, I heard the second living being say, "Come." Then another horse appeared, a red one. Its rider was given a mighty sword and the authority to take peace from the earth. And there was war and slaughter everywhere. When the Lamb broke the third seal, I heard the third living being say, "Come." I looked up and saw a black horse, and its rider was holding a pair of scales in his hand. And I heard a voice from among the four living beings say, "A loaf of wheat bread or three loaves of barley will cost a day's pay. And don't waste the olive oil and wine." When the Lamb broke the fourth seal, I heard the fourth living being say, "Come." I looked up and saw a horse whose color was pale green. Its rider was named Death, and his companion was the grave. These two were given authority over one-fourth of the earth to kill with the sword and famine and disease and wild animals. Last week we talked about the number four and what it symbolized, how it tied us to the physical realm and how it pointed to the earth. We also talked about the four horses. We talked about what horses symbolize. We talked about the color of the horse. This week, we're going to take a look at the riders of these four horses. Verse 2 tells us that the rider of the white horse had a crown, had authority, and had a bow. In the Bible, a crown signifies authority, and a bow signifies the word of God. We're also told in verse 2 that this rider came conquering and to conquer. Well, there is only one person, Christ, who comes in our life to conquer sin. The verse goes on to say, the rider comes conquering, which indicates that the whole process of removing sin from our life is in fact a process. Salvation is a process, and Christ continues conquering. He continues removing the sin from our life on a daily basis until we are perfected. So this rider on the white horse is Christ, coming with authority from God, coming with the word of God to remove sin from our lives. Verse 4 introduces us to the next rider, the rider of the red horse. We're told that this rider comes with a sword, a great sword. And as we look at the Greek word, a great sword is actually more of a dagger. It's more of a long knife, and is often used for sacrifice. It is used to prepare an animal for sacrifice, used to remove sin. The knife is also used to slaughter an animal for food. And so we find that this second rider has come with a knife, come to slaughter, and he also says he comes to remove peace. Well, here's the thing about that. In Matthew 10, we read that Jesus Christ says, "I came to the world not to bring peace, but I came bringing a sword." The sword represents the Word of God. And Christ comes and brings the Word of God into our lives. That Word of God removes sin. It removes impurities. It takes those things from our life. It cuts those things out of our life that do not need to be there. Hence the red horse, hence the sword. Jesus Christ comes to cut some things out of our life. Verse 5 tells us that the rider of the black horse comes with a pair of scales. Now, I know they didn't have a scale like this back in Bible days. They had more of the scales you see Lady Justice holding, a scale with two sides. And the reason they have two sides is because they are weighing different products in the balance. They are checking to see if there is balance. Oftentimes they used scales in the Bible to cheat people. They would rig the scale so that people were maybe paying more or getting less for what they were paid for. The scales were not fair. They were not just. In the Bible, scales are to represent justice. And that is why Christ comes into our life, to bring things into balance. Christ comes and brings justice. He comes to represent what is right and what is good. Sometimes in our life with our ego, sometimes our ego will have us doing some things that are not quite right. And our ego and our desires, our natural tendencies, tend to outweigh the Spirit of Christ in our life. And so the scale comes along more so for us to weigh some things in our life. And technically, we don't need a physical scale. We kind of know if our life is out of balance. We know that if it's more of our flesh, more of our nature, more of our ego taking over than the Word of God. Nevertheless, the black horse brings a pair of scales. We're told that the rider of the fourth horse, comes, and his name is Death. Hades, or the grave, is following behind him. And he brings four judgments with him. Now, again, we're looking at a rider named Death. We're looking at the grave following behind. And you might right away start thinking about what's going on today. You think about the pandemic. You think about COVID-19, especially since we're talking about judgments. However, remember that we are looking at this text symbolically and mythically. What does death represent, that rider? What do the judgments represent? I'm glad you asked. There are some things, again, that have to die in our lives. There are some things that will die in our life. I can promise you now that spiritually, to be where we need to be where God wants us to be, there will be some things that spiritually have to die in our life. Christ comes along to bring about that transformation. He brings judgments with him. There are judgments that we will deal with. This verse talks about famine. It talks about war. It talks about pestilence. It talks about wild beasts. When we look at famine, famine is basically a scarcity of food, a scarcity of bread, if you will. Bread represents the Word of God. So there's a scarcity sometimes in our lives for the Word of God. So ask yourself right now, is there scarcity in my life when it comes to the Word of God? If there is, we need to take some steps. God is bringing about a desire. There's a hunger in us. There's a hunger in America today for the Word of God. And because that Word is not present, we are experiencing a spiritual famine. We need for the Word of God to be available to us. The second judgment talks about war. There is a war going on in each of us. There's a battle going on in each of us. Again, as the ego rises up against the Spirit of God, as our flesh rises up against the Spirit, there's a battle that goes on. There's a war that's going on. And sometimes it's a pretty intense war. It is spiritual warfare. But those things are used, those judgments are used to bring our attention back to God. Then he talks about pestilence. Pestilence is disease. Again, COVID-19, a disease. Some people would say dis-ease. Dis-ease, meaning there's no rest, there's no relaxation, you're constantly worried, you're constantly troubled, you're sad, you're depressed, you're fighting, you're struggling, your body is at dis-ease, and you are in need of peace. And sometimes God will let us go to that place and be in that place in order to bring us back to himself. And then the final judgment talks about wild beast. Well, now, wild beast, I know you could probably say, now, how does that relate spiritually? We see wild beasts all the time. Well, maybe don't see them all the time, thank goodness. But there are wild beasts spiritually in our lives. There are those things within us that attack us from within. In the Bible, wild beasts symbolized problems, symbolized trouble, symbolized things that were going on that should not be going on in our life. God will allow things to go on in our life to bring us back to himself. So when we think about the lockdown, when we think about the quarantine, when we think about separation from friends, all of those things can be kind of like a wild beast in our lives. And sometimes things are much worse than that. Nevertheless, the whole point in this lesson, the whole point with the horses, with the colors, with the riders, with the judgment, is that God is trying to transform his people. God is trying to draw us back to himself, and he's revealing to us that there will be times and ways in which he will do that. Now, I'm pretty sure most of this doesn't make a lot of sense to you. Revelation is deep. Revelation has a lot of symbols. Revelation has a lot going on. But I would encourage you, because we're told to do so in that first chapter, I would encourage you to start reading the book. Read through it. Study it. Get to know some of the symbolism. You have the internet now. You can easily look this stuff up. Get to know what the symbolism means. But most of all, if you do nothing else, if you do nothing else, rather than looking at what's going on in our outside world, rather than looking at COVID-19, being out of school, online learning, rather than looking at all of that stuff, start looking within. Start asking God, what are you doing on the inside of me? How are you transforming me? What judgments are taking place within me in order that I might be turned back to you? God loves us. Jesus loves us. And all that happens, all that he does, is to draw us back to himself. And with that, we have no reason to be afraid. Let's pray. Gracious God, thank you so much for this time today. Thank you for this message. Thank you for the book of Revelation. It can indeed be a scary book, God. But as we look at it symbolically, as we look at it mythically, as we look at how you are working in our lives, we can rest assured that you are doing what is best for us and you are drawing us back to yourself. So give us understanding, give us clarity, give us wisdom, and help us to trust you in the days that lie ahead and in the days of our lives within. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.